Hello people, welcome back to another episode of Relating Me and You, You and Me through YouTube. And here I am with another look which is looking absolutely stunning. What do you think? Anyways, this look was requested by one of my subscribers where she said that I should put together a look which has skincare and makeup but which is real quick to achieve because it should not take more than 10 minutes. After all, we don't have so much time with us and we want to look put together, we want to look presentable, but at the same time we cannot spend too much time on doing full face of makeup YouTube style. So I have come up with this look which consists of very few steps and which are very easy to achieve. So it takes care that your skin is well done, your skincare is properly done before putting on any makeup, and I have added few minimum essential steps of makeup that I feel are essential. Obviously this is very subjective, differs from person to person, but for me these steps are essential that I have done here. I'm going to start by toning my face. I am going to use my toner as my cleanser and take away all the oil that's there on my face. And if you are the one who has just taken bath or just washed their face, can directly start by toning it instead of using it with a cleanser. So any which ways, you have to use a toner. And for toner, I am using this Kaya Skin Toner. It's excellent for co-care and also it's alcohol free. And whenever you are using a toner, make sure you shake it well before using. And since I am using it for cleansing, I am going to take it on a cotton pad. Generally, I don't take it on a cotton pad if I have washed my face or if I have taken bath. I don't take it on a cotton pad. But since this is cleansing away the oil, I am going to take it on a cotton pad. And I must tell you that toner is the best thing you can use to cleanse your face before doing makeup because it takes away all the dirt, all the oil from your face. So I'm doing that. Next step we are going to follow is moisturizing. As this is going to be a quick makeup routine, the skincare is also supposed to be very quick. So I'm using this Clinique Moisture Surge and going to take 2 pumps of it and moisturize. You can use any moisturizer that you use. Now in this video, the products that I show are not important that they have to be same when you are doing your routine. You can follow whatever you want, whatever products you want. I'm just trying to tell you here that how you can, you know, really quickly do, because I've seen a lot of people who are working and they have this reason that since they are working, they have to go early, they don't have time for all this, for skincare and everything. So I'm trying to tell you the minimum steps that you need to do to make sure that your skin looks nice and you look presentable. Now for makeup, I'm going to start with this Wet n Wild makeup setting spray. This is very important. This step is very important because this is for working people who want really long lasting makeup because they don't have time to touch up throughout the day. So this step is going to make sure that your makeup stays on all day long. So setting spray is going to act as your primer and make sure you dab it properly into your skin and let your face become a little tacky. You have to reach the stage where your setting spray turns tacky and not dry, because once it's dry, the whole purpose will not be achieved. So just make it a little tacky. If you see, it has become tacky, just the right amount. And I'm going to start with the next step. Now I'm going to start with this MAC concealer palette. And I am going to take the shade which is closest to my skin tone. And I'm just going to make sure to cover all the pigmentation, and if there are any dark circles or anything like that, just cover it up with your concealer, with your fingers. You don't need any brush, any beauty blender, you don't need anything for this step at least. Nice and well. Don't seem to glorify desires. It's purely visceral, it's not too late to win this war against this picture game. Now I'm going to let the concealer set in a little bit and I'm going to start with the eyebrows. and this is what I am using for my brows. That's L'Oreal Paris Brow Artist Kit. I'm going to use this. This is the one that is really helpful when you want to do something really quick. You don't have time. I think this is the one you should go for. It's my high year. After brows, next step is going to be a BB cream. You can obviously go for a foundation by all means, but here I am trying to show something that is very natural looking, very quick. So I think BB cream works the best in that case, and especially the Rimmel ones. This is the most stunning BB cream that I have ever seen. It is just so beautiful, and it makes your skin look just completely natural and still so healthy and so taken care of. I'm going to use my fingers for this, because again, not everybody has those tools like Beauty Blender and everything. I think BB cream can work just fine with your fingers if you do it in a right manner. Base is all done, and next I'm going to go for is blush. I am going blush before powder is because I'm going for a cream blush. I am going to use my lipstick by L'Oreal Paris in the shade Rose Nuance. This is a very, very, very beautiful shade, perfect for your blush, for Indian skin tones, and as a lipstick as well. Very nice and very blendable. Now the trick for applying cream blush is that the finger with which you take the blush, it has to be different from the finger by which you are trying to blend your brush. Now I am taking my blush with this finger, so I dab 2-3 dots with this, and then I use another finger to blend it so that you don't over put the blush, and at the same time the blush has to be blended really well so that it looks very natural like this. Also, when you're blending, you make sure you blend all the edges really well and there are no edges to your blush. Only then it will look natural, otherwise it will look patchy and it won't give a very flaunting look. Next step comes is a loose powder. I am using this Color Bar loose powder, which is perfect for daily use because this is the one that stays all day long and helps in not creasing of the makeup, and at the same time does not make your skin look oily and keeps the oil at bay all day long again. So I'm going to use this with a brush. Now this step again is very, very, very important because, as I said, this is going to help your oils away from your face. That way your makeup will stay longer. So having a loose powder is extremely important. I'm going to take a little bit. Don't overdo this because otherwise your whole criteria of keeping everything natural will just go away. So I'm going to start with my T-zone because that is what turns oily for me the most. So I'm going to concentrate the major part of powder on my P-zone. If you see, there's nothing actually there on the lid, just the residue that I am going to use, and I'm going to use this to settle my blush. Because it is a cream blush, there are chances that it may fade away. So to settle everything down, just dab a residue of the powder on it so that your face doesn't turn oily. But don't use a powder which is little too pigmented, because then your blush will not be seen from the powder. You'll just cover everything with the powder. So whatever powder that you're using has to have minimum pigmentation. Now comes the eyes. Now this is very subjective. To what extent do you want to take your eye look? What is natural eye look for you and what is really glam eye look for you? It is very subjective and differs from person to person. So I am going to try to make it simple, which looks natural for me, but it may be overdone for you. So you can completely, you know, switch up the steps that you want and keep the rest that you don't want. I'm going to start with this Maybelline gel eyeliner. This is an all-purpose liner, good for kajal or liner or anything, smoky eyes, whatever you want. You can do everything with this. So I'm taking a liner brush and gel liner, and I'm just going to draw a very thin fine line along the waterline. That's just too bad. Go and moan, go and moan, go and moan, dear. You lost your gemstone and it hangs free around my neck. And you'll have to let it go, leave it be, let me be clear. It's my high ear. After lining my upper and lower waterline, you can completely stop at this if you want and you feel this is enough for you. But for me, I cannot just stay without color. So I'm going to add this liner. This is brown maroon kind of a shade. I'm going to add this liner over top of the black upper line. Only the upper waterline, not down. So next step is mascara. I'm using this NYX Worth the Hype mascara. Okay, another trick to use mascara in the best way possible so that it gives you best possible results is, first coat is going to be a completely layered brush. You are just going to apply one coat with this, just one coat, and don't overdo it. When this one coat is done, the next coat is going to be, you have to clean the brush properly. There should be no mascara on your blush, on your brush. And then you're going to again go through whatever you have applied earlier. So this way, if you have clumsy lashes or anything like that, this is going to make sure that it is free of everything. And your lashes are individually long and voluminous. You'll never find someone better, better than me. I'm the one who owns eyes, will hide the key. That's all for eyes, and our next step is going to be setting spray again, so that again makeup stays all day long. And cover your eyes so that your mascara and eyeliner does not bleed with the setting spray. And then let it dry. And the last and final step is going to be lipstick. I am using this L'Oreal Paris Color Rich Matte in the shade Rose Nuance again. The one that I used for blush. I love this lipstick. You can see I've almost finished it. this is how the look has turned out. This is what you can easily carry all day long without any hustle into your office or any other work that you do. So this makes you look absolutely beautiful, very presentable, very put together, and at the same time is very quick and easy to achieve. And let me know what do you think about this look. You can easily subtract or add the makeup steps that you want in this makeup look, but these are the essential steps for me, which I achieve in like less than 10 minutes, and they're very easy and simple to do, and still it looks like you have put in enough efforts to look presentable. Let me know what do you think about this look. If you like it, give this video a big fat thumbs up. And if there is anything that you want me to make videos on, please drop it in the comment section below. I'll be more than happy to do it. And guys, please do not forget to subscribe to the channel. Until then, take care. Ta-da!